إلهي وقفت دموعي تسيل.
And understand this, young Muslims. Today, you have the same type of problems. Sin hasn't gone to your neighbor's house. It has come into your bedroom. You call it a laptop. Sin has come onto your pillows. You call it mobile phones. You sit there watching TV till you feel like you're vomiting. So you go, oh, khalas. You know, click. And then there's nothing there after a few hours, so khalas. Then you go to your laptop and you sit and you watch. Halal and haram, may Allah Rabbul Izzah guide you to halal. Then when you're nothing is left and you're on the pillow, you're still playing with your little phone. Sin has come into your bedrooms. Sin has become pervasive and invasive and engulfing and all overtaking. And this time, watch two things. Watch falling for the sin, especially in seclusion. Listen to this hadith. And وَرَبُّ الْكَعْبَ, it should make the hairs on the back of your neck stand. Listen to the warning of the Sadiq al-Masduq. لَأَعْلَمَنَّ أَقْوَامًا مِنْ أُمَّتِي, I know groups of my ummah, يَأْتُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِحَسَنَاتٍ أَمْثَالِ جِبَالِ تِهَامَّةَ بَيْضَاء, they will come in the day of judgment with good deeds like mountains glowing bright. Not little too good, mountain of good deeds. So Allah Rabbul Izzah says, فَيَجْعَلُهَا اللَّهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا, and Allah Rabbul Izzah will make it perish in the wind. It will disappear. So the Rasul says, أَمَا إِنَّهُمْ مِنْ إِخْوَانِكُمْ, these are not ordinary, they're your brothers, Muslims. And not ordinary Muslims. وَيَأْخُذُونَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ كَمَا تَأْخُذُونَ, and these are Muslims, the type that wake up in the middle of the night and pray. They're good Muslims. But what's their sin? وَلَكِنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ إِذَا خَلَوْا بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ إِنْتَهَكُوهَا, but there are people that when they're alone, they overstep the boundaries of Allah. So in seclusion, when you're there on your phone, remember, Allah will delete all your good deeds if you're not careful. Allah will, if you grow the jurrah, the bravery against the Zul Arsh al-Majid, that you know he's watching, and you feel he's watching, and you persist. One is out of fear and mistakes in you, but out of insistence, fear that. And second, Bushara, for those of you that have the capacity and ability to hold back from the haram, listen to the glad tidings. The Prophet, and I will end with this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ أَيَّامَ الصَّبْرِ, or Sahaba, after you will come the days of patience, the days of difficulty, the days where it is hard to be a Muslim and righteous. But لِلْمُتَمَسِّكِ فِيهَا بِمَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ, but whoever in those days of difficulties and in those days of vice and in those days of the internet, if in those days whoever holds on to what you have held on to, if they hold on to the deen as you are holding, O Sahaba, لَهُمْ أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ, they will get the reward of 50. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, خَمْسِين مِنَّا أَمْ مِنْهُمْ, the reward of 50 of us or 50 of them. So the Rasul said, بَلْ مِنْكُمْ, no, 50 of you, my Sahaba. And whoever leaves a haram for the sake of Allah and returns it for a halal, Allah Rabbul Izzah replaces it with unimaginable things. The Ashab gave up their homes for Islam. Allah gave them the dominion of the earth instead. Sulaiman alayhi salam gave up his horses for the sake of Allah. Allah gave him the wind to command. Yusuf alayhi salam gave up a haram woman. Allah gave him the dominion of Egypt instead. Leave the haram that you're in. In warabbul Kaaba, Allah will replace it with what you didn't anticipate. May Allah guide and guard you. فَقُلْتُ مَا قُلْتُ إِنْ تَكُ حَسَنَةً فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَإِنْ تَكُ سَيِّئَةً فَمِنْ نَفْسِي وَالشَّيْطَانِ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.